Hey there! In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build your own AI-powered LinkedIn content generator using WeWeb, n8n, and OpenAI. I'll explain where you can get the free WeWeb and n8n templates to build this on your own in 15 minutes or less. I'll show you exactly what you need to update and give you a few tips on how to improve those templates to build your own SaaS product on top of it. But first, let's have a look at the end result of the apps available in the template. So this is the UI I went for. The user enters their OpenAI key. They can update this prompt with their specific needs, and then they can generate 6 LinkedIn topics. So this, when I click this button, it triggers an n8n webhook that generates 6 topics through OpenAI. Now I have these topics, the user has these topics available, and we can just edit them. So streamlining your content calendar with AI automation, that's great. As solopreneurs, maybe we say as SMBs, juggle multiple tasks, we can edit it. And then we can trigger another n8n webhook by clicking on generating post. Okay. Now we have a LinkedIn post with some text and potentially a few hashtags depending on the topic. We can copy paste it and publish it to LinkedIn if we want to, or we can generate an image. This will trigger a third n8n webhook that also calls on OpenAI. All right, now I have an image. I can download it or regenerate it, whatever I choose. And the reasoning for breaking down this automation in 3 webhooks is to give more control to the end users. But of course, you can decide to change that and change the n8n template and the WeWeb template so it just generates the entire content in one go. It's just that in terms of user experience, it's not my preference because the user has to wait longer for content that they're potentially not agreeing with. So I like to give them more control with the ability to edit the topics, for example. Okay, so this UI is built in WeWeb. The entire logic is built in n8n. Let's have a look at how you can recreate this app in under 10-15 minutes for free. Okay, so you'll go to the marketplace, the WeWeb marketplace, and get the template, the LinkedIn content generator template. So I'll get this template. It will create the project in my workspace, and I can just open it and edit it as I see fit. All right, and in n8n, the n8n marketplace, I can look for AI-powered LinkedIn content generator, the one created by WeWeb, and I will use it for free. I will get started, in my case, with this. I create a brand new account. And for now, I'm going to skip this. I will show you exactly how that works and how to update this. But first, I want to show you what the template looks like. So remember I mentioned 3 webhooks? This is the first n8n webhook to generate topics. Then we have a second one to generate a single post with related hashtags. And then we have the one to generate an image. So I'm going to need to update the URLs of these webhooks in WeWeb. So let me take the production URL, copy this, and then in my WeWeb project, I'm going to look for the form container. So the first workflow is on form submit. We generate topics. So I'm going to update my action here with the n8n webhook. And I also have a disabled action for testing. So I'm going to update this with a test URL from n8n. Okay. Now let me try this and see if it works. Okay. It doesn't. I get an error. Why? Because I did not activate my workflow. Please resolve outstanding issues before you activate it. Okay, so I need to update the open chat model first. So here I need to create credentials. And the thing is, I want my users to be able to enter their own OpenAI key. I don't want to connect my own OpenAI account. I'd rather make the app available for free to users, but then, you know, I don't want it to cost me any money. So I'm gonna set up credentials that are actually a variable that will take the variable from the input sent by WeWeb. Okay, so I'm gonna create new credentials and my API key will be an expression. I wanted to take the input that WeWeb is gonna send to NA10. So if I go back to my WeWeb project, here it's an input from the user. And here I am sending the API key from that input. Don't worry, I will delete it later so you can't steal it from me. This is a secret key. We're not storing it anywhere in the app. We're just preserving it on navigation so that we still have access to it when the user is redirected to the second page. Okay, so I want this. I'm sending this information to NA10, and I want NA10 to be able to do something with it. So it's going to be the body from the JSON, from the JSON that it receives from WeWeb, and API key. All right, so let's save this. The OpenAI account. Actually, I will rename it OpenAI User Input. Just to be a little bit more explicit to remember that it's not my own API key. All right, now that I fixed this issue, and do I have the same issue here? Let's fix it now. OpenAI, that's good. Let's fix it now as well. Perfect. And we have it here, HTTP request. Okay, here we are using the same credentials. So all good now. I should not have any errors left in my NA10 workflow. Perfect, so I'll save this and I will activate it. Yes, I understand. Now let me clear the logs and try again. So in preview mode, I will click on this. The request was made, so that's good. And I am redirected here. Now, the user is allowed to edit, and I want to make sure I update the URL for the second webhook. So let's go here and edit the topic pop-up. I'm going to edit this generate post button. And here I will update with the URL of the second webhook. So the second webhook is here. I'll first update the production URL. Here we go. And then I will update the test URL. There we go. Okay, let's see if that works. I'm gonna generate a post. All right, view the generated content. Very cool. I have my content, my hashtags. I can copy it. And I can also generate an image. First, again, I'm gonna have to update this button and make sure I get to the workflow and update the URLs of the webhook. So production URL, there we go. And then the tests URL, I will update here. And if I want to use the test URL, you know, I can here, I can activate it, and then I would disable the production URL. Okay, let's switch back to preview, and I'll just clear the logs again, generate the image. Okay, the call went through fine. And there we go. I can regenerate the image if I want to. I can download the image, whatever I choose to do. So that's how you can make this AI-powered LinkedIn content generator your own. And, you know, you could just deploy it and publish it for free on a WeWeb subdomain, But you can also improve it. You can turn it into a full-blown SaaS product and actually, you know, sell it, make it available to other people. A few ideas for that would be adding user authentication so that they can save this, because right now the topics are saved in local storage, so in the user's browser. But you could save those to your backend. If you set up a proper backend, then you can also improve the NA10 AI so that the AI learns from the user's additions. So when the user edits a topic, for example, then the AI learns from that and little by little gives better and better topics, or topics that are more and more relevant to the user. You can also improve the UI, so make it like really slick and, you know, a beautiful experience. Lots of things you can do to improve this, but hopefully you already have a lot of fun with this. You already learn a lot, and yeah, happy building. If you'd like me to create any other of these types of videos, if you have a use case that you've been meaning to try but you're struggling with it and you'd like us to put together a build guide, please do not hesitate to let me know in the comments, and I will do my best to deliver. All right, thanks everyone. Don't forget to subscribe to the WeWeb YouTube channel.